Welcome back. The United States registered almost 2,000 deaths from COVID-19 on Wednesday. That's the highest daily figure for any country since the start of the pandemic. It brings the total there to almost 15,000, higher even than Spain. With unemployment soaring, millions are struggling just to put food on the table. Meanwhile, in rural America, produce there is going to waste. Caleb Maupin reports.
Sometimes we seem to live in parallel realities. Across the United States, store shelves are empty, and food banks are reporting long lines and a shortage of donations. But at the same time, we have farmers across America dumping gallons and gallons of dairy products, saying that they have no one to buy them. How is this even possible? Demand for milk and cheese and other dairy products is high, yet they are unable to sell them. The pandemic is requiring self-isolation. Bars and restaurants are closed. As a result, people are running to their local supermarkets and the shelves are quite empty. Most American farmers are wholesalers, meaning they sell to retailers, not directly to supermarkets. And if you are a farmer who sells to a retailer that supplies restaurants, they cannot buy anything. So you have to rapidly reorient to selling to supermarkets.
The problem is the factories or milk processors who are producing products specifically for the retail industry, like restaurants, for example, those little tiny packs of butter that you may get in a restaurant. Well, you can't just take that to the grocery store and sell it to the consumer.
It's not just milk. Meat and vegetables are in a similar situation. Producers do not have enough customers left, and supermarket chains are unable to restock when they run out. Lots of food is going to waste. In addition, tighter border controls are making it harder for producers to hire immigrant workers. With harvest just around the corner, this presents a big problem. It could lead to fruits and crops rotting in the fields with no workforce to reap them. Many are wondering why all the food that's being thrown away due to market disruptions cannot just be provided to food banks.
If you wanted to reorganize it, to move the milk not according to the market where it will be paid for, but to give it to charity, you would have to reorganize the wholesale, the storage, the transport, and that's precisely the kind of arranging that could only be done if it were planned for in advance. At this point, it's haphazard. We don't have train traffic as we normally did. We do not have truck traffic as we normally did. There is no coordination. The major effort of the government is to appear to be in control when it isn't. It's a government that is focused on re-election and not on dealing with this problem. It's really like the 1930s, the Great Depression, coming down into the United States economy.
The crisis unfolding in the United States seems to be bad for everyone. Hungry people cannot get food from food banks. Consumers, ready to buy food, find empty shelves in stores. Meanwhile, farmers have to dump their product because they are unable to sell it. Caleb Maupin, RT, New York.